had what I came for. It was time to get out. Now.
I have brought us honor and glory.
Your Majesty, you promised me my choice of Maharaja's treasures. That dagger!
Surely you won't deny the lad a souvenir of his first battle. You may have your choice of all the Maharaja's other treasures. Except that hourglass. That will make a fine gift for the Sultan of Azad when we pass through his city. And some exotic animals for his menagerie. And a few dozen slave girls. Yes, that should be enough.
I want no animals or maidens harmed until I have chosen. Let it be known, King Saruman is merciful in victory.
Trust not a man who has betrayed his master, nor take him into your own service, lest he betray you too. I learned the truth of this, to my sorrow, the day that we arrived in Azad as the Sultan's honored guests.
My friend,
your visit brings joy and honor to my poor and humble dwelling. If only you'd given me time to prepare a proper welcome.
The glories of Azad are famed throughout the world.
And yet,
the best is yet to come. I give you the sands of time. May the friendship between our kingdoms endure as long as time itself.
The sand, why does it glow?
I can tell you. Inside the hourglass is a marvel that no living man has seen. Alas, only the dagger can unlock the sands of time, and it belongs to a greater one than I. A young prince, dearer to his father than all the wealth of India. Perhaps he will oblige.
No!
Use the dagger. his sand. Now, finish.
Each time I struck them down, they rose to fight again. I soon realized that only by taking into my own dagger the sands that possessed them, could I liberate them from their monstrous living death. I'll start the story from here next time. You think me mad. I can see it by the look in your eyes. You think my story is impossible. But perhaps I am mad. Who would not be driven mad by horrors such as I have lived? But I assure you, every word is true.
it! Stop! I won't hurt you!
The guest rooms, where my father, all our entourage, and I should have passed the night, lay cold and silent. The sands of time had swept through, stealing life and warmth from everything they touched. And I, who unleashed the cataclysm, had been spared. Were there others like me, who yet clung to life, hiding in fear among the ruins? It did not seem so.
Is anyone there? Come back!
Had I really seen her? Or had my senses given way under the burden of horrors too great to bear and conjured up a phantom? Either way, I could not rest until I had found her again.